हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, फॉर टर्म वन क्लास 10th सीबीएसई बोर्ड एग्ज़ाम दिस इज़ द लिस्ट ऑफ मैथ्स आइटम्स एंड द टोटल नंबर ऑफ मैथ्स विच आर कमिंग फ्रॉम चैप्टर वन थ्री एंड चैप्टर फोर। सो चैप्टर वन यू कैन सी द मेजर सॉइल टाइप्स एंड फ्रॉम चैप्टर थ्री देर आर सलाल डैम, टेरी डैम, सरदार सरोवर डैम, नार्जन नागार्जुन सागर डैम, भाखर नागर डैम, राणा प्रताप सागर, हीराकुंड, तुंगभद्रा एंड फ्रॉम एग्रीकल्चर मेजर एरियाज ऑफ राइस एंड वीट एंड द लार्जेस्ट मेजर प्रोड्यूसर स्टेट्स ऑफ शुगर केन, टी, कॉफ़ी, रबर, कॉटन एंड जूट। तो लेट्स सी इन द एनसीईआरटी बुक द मैप वर्क विच इज़ गिवन। इफ यू सी इन द एनसीईआरटी बुक दे हैव गिवन एरुवियल सॉइल, रेड सॉइल, ब्लैक सॉइल, लिटरेट सॉइल एंड एरिड सॉइल। फॉर दिस यू शुड नो द स्टेट्स एंड यू शुड मेक अ पॉलिटिकल मैप एंड इन दैट यू कैन सी द स्टेट्स हैविंग द लार्जेस्ट एरिया ऑफ एरुवियल सॉइल आर पंजाब, हरियाणा, उत्तर प्रदेश, बिहार, आसाम, वेस्ट बंगाल एंड सम पार्ट्स ऑफ गुजरात ऑल्सो as well as Rajasthan, but the largest area is covered by the northern plains and especially in Uttar Pradesh, and this is the most richest soil and mountain soil. Naturally, as the name is found on the mountain, then if you see the black soil, major area in Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, some part of Karnataka, red soil on the eastern coast. And you can see in Chhattisgarh, Odisha, in south, if you see, it is Tamil Nadu and some part of Kerala. Arid soil, which is with yellow color in Rajasthan, western part of India, and it is useless, not useful for any type of agriculture, right? And then it comes laterite soil, it is on the coastal regions in pink color, and on the western side in eastern coast we have fertile soil, alluvial soil. So if you see next chapter in NCERT, so water resource, and when we go to move to water resource chapter 3, we are having only the map up here, and you can see the map. In map you have to study not only the dams but also the rivers, only then you can remember the dams which are built on a particular river and with their state as UT. If you see Salal Dam is built on river Chenab, and earlier it was Jammu Kashmir state, but now it is UT. So Salal project, river Chenab, and the union territory is Jammu and Kashmir. Next is Bhakra Nagar Dam. If you see river on Satluj, and this is the one of the second highest dam of India with 2 to 5 meters height. Then comes, and the state is when Bhakra comes it is in Himachal Pradesh, and when comes Nagar it is in Punjab. These are two different dams. Then comes Tehri Dam. If you see Tehri Dam in Uttarakhand, and we say river Ganga, but actually it is river on Bhagirathi. Then moves towards Rajasthan. If you see, the river is Chambal, and we are having a Kota barrage there, then Rana Pratap Sagar, then Gandhi Sagar. Moves towards south, if you see Sardar Sarovar Dam, and it is built on river Narmada. He moves towards south, the dam is Nagarjuna Sagar, and the river is Krishna, and the same Krishna river moves towards when we see in the western part the dam is Koyna, and these rivers originate from the western ghats and moves towards east. Same with river Tungbhadra, and the dam is Tungbhadra. State is Karnataka, towards south, if you see, the river is Kaveri and the dam is Mettu, and so important for term 1 exam CBSE board. And then we move to Kerala, state Kerala, river Periyar, dam Periyar, and we have lake Periyar, we have wildlife Periyar here also. And Mettu dam, it comes in state Tamil Nadu. When we move towards upwards, we see river Damodar in West Bengal, and moves towards Jharkhand. In Jharkhand, and the dam is Damodar. Then we move to Odisha state, river Mahanadi, and the dam is Hirakund. Again towards south, we move to river Godavari, and this NCERT book doesn't show any dam here, so we will leave it as it, and we will move to the next chapter, and that is agriculture. And with agriculture, we will see they have shown a one map of rice maize areas with the dark colors and the minor areas with light colors. If you see, the eastern part of India produce a large amount of rice. So in crops, you have to write the names, the major producer of sugarcane, tea, coffee, rubber, cotton and jute. And for that, you can use the help from your Google and your book also. For latest data, you have to see on your Google. Then this is the wheat production area. If you see, this is the western part of India, and especially Punjab, Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh, and then comes some part of Uttarakhand, and the MP also have large areas of wheat production. So this is it, and you have to pay for this list, and this is enough for your term 1 exam for CBSE board. Thank you.